Hi, I'm Camille, Process Engineer at Eficad, and today we are going to talk about SWOOD 2022 updates. Hey! Among the new features in SWOOD 2022, we'll be seeing the updates in SWOOD CAM.
Regarding SWOOD CAM, we will cover 6 different topics, starting with 3 new automatic machining strategies, a new trajectory optimization on 5-axis machinings, and maybe the biggest new feature on SWOOD CAM that is based on the link between the strategies library and the machining inserted in your 3D models. And finally, another machining strategy allowing you to cut parts without any head jams. So let's start with the first automatic operation. As you can see in the video, we drag and drop the machining strategy from the library, and here we are inserting the auto pocket machinings and the resume pocket angle with cutter compensation. Let's have a look deeper by editing it. So we will have the pocket and the new resume pocket with cutter compensation milling that is automatically created. Let's look at it together now and in the simulation with material removal. Okay, perfect. And a quick reminder on the cutter compensation that allows us to program toolpath centered along with the part features rather than needing to offset the toolpath geometry to compensate for the tool size. And here on the images, you can see that by creating it with the pocket machining, I automatically have the previous tool diameter detected and I only need to add lead-in and lead-out offsets. Let's now jump to the chamfer operation. In link with the new features of SWOOD design we have seen previously, we have the new operation, which is the automatic chamfer operation. So obviously, this operation is automatic, as you can see it on the video there. We only need to drag and drop the strategy from the library to detect all the countersink holes. And finally, let's check into the simulation mode of SWOOD. Perfect. And let's continue with the next new machinings. This new machining strategy allows to mill open contour as pockets and avoids any scrap during the milling process. This is especially for our CNC drilling machines with 6 faces or vertical ones. So in the video, we are creating it from scratch. So I insert the tool I want to use for the operation. I select machinings, the tool, and the operation outline open pockets. So we automatically detect the geometry and we can now change the path strategy. And it's done. We have our new automatic strategy fully defined and ready to reuse. So we keep going with the 5-axis optimization. This new option is done on the 3D finishing operation. You can see in the video that we are using the same method to create 3D milling. So we select the surface body, then the 3D milling, we select the tool that we want to use, and then the operation which is finishing here. We still have the same interface except for the new icon on the right hand, which is the new options. To activate it, I only need to click on the button and define the minimum distance between each step. And the trajectory is now updated. And we have here the simulation results that shows the differences between each strategy, so we can clearly see the benefits of the new optimization. Let's go now for the linked machining library features. Okay, so first, I will open several parts and drag and drop the same automatic linked machinings on all of them. To have something visual, we have inserted here a sawing operation with a tool of 300 mm. Until now, we are still on the classic way of working for my strategic machinings. But now, I can right-click on the strategy used and edit it. You can notice that on the right-hand side of the windows, we have the type defined as linked. That allows us to update all machinings inserted at once. Now, I select the operation and I have access to all the operation parameters on the right that I can update at any moment. So here, I'm changing the tool and the cutting strategy to a downcut. And now, once rebuilt, all my operations are now completely updated with the value of the new parameters. And just a few words now to understand how we can do it. Once we have edited the machining strategy, we can define its type and choose if we want to link, if we want a linked machining or a regular one, and then define the value of the different parameters depending on the needs. Now regarding the behavior of the features, a machining strategy can be unlinked at any moment, but cannot be relinked once unlinked. We are now coming to the last SWOOD CAM new features, which is also a new machining strategy called the Staydown contour. This operation is going to create trajectories without any tool jams, and this optimization is up to 20% more efficient than a conventional contour. I think that you have understood that this operation is particularly useful to cut out the nesting sheets.
If you want to know more about SWOOD and our solutions, do not forget to click on the subscribe button and do not hesitate to contact us on our website, swood.efficant.com. See you soon!